Hi, welcome to Java Hangout channel. In this video, we will see how to convert a string to list. Converting a string into list. So, in real time, every developer definitely, I believe, come across this type of requirements where we need to convert the string into list to do some operations. Okay, for example, if you see here, this is one requirement, states abbreviations like AP, AR, AN, AS, BR. So we don't know what is AP, what is AR, what is KL, what is KA. So we will get input as a abbreviation. We have to return the full form of that abbreviations. As we know, AP means Andhra Pradesh and KA means Karnataka, WB means West Bengal, KL means Kerala, like that. This is the one requirement. So it is very often we see this type of requirements, and this is just one simple example I'm going to show you. In one of my friend asked me there is a property file where all the users are configured, and based on users he has to decide return the group, you know, roles will be there, right? Like admin role, developer role, and different roles will be there. So based on user, he has to return the roles. That is the example. All the names are configured in property file. First he has to read that one, and convert that string into array list to do some operations to get the appropriate role. So that was the requirement. And here I am showing simple example. Okay. Let's see. Jump into the practical. So here I already define a class to meet our requirement. So just I am not taking any property file here. Directly, it is simple example. Our main aim is how to convert the string into array list to do some operations. So these are the states abbreviations AP, AR, AN, AS, all those things. Okay, then mapping will be there in hash map. So AP means Andhra Pradesh, KA means Karnataka, AR means Arunachal Pradesh, BR means Bihar, and KL means Kerala, WB means West Bengal. These are the things generally we use. So if you see any vehicle, AP means Andhra Pradesh, by using that we come to know. So this is the requirement. Okay, already instead of property file, I am using a simple static string method, a string variable. Okay, and this is the regular expression. So delimiter we use, right? Here comma separated, so that these all whatever value is there, so it has to be converted into the array list. So how can we split this one? There should be one delimiter, that is comma. So I am using. Okay, so I defined one separate method, that is a string to list. Real time we have to use like this only, so that tomorrow it can be used in different scenarios where instead of states, abbreviations, so and regular expression is comma, instead of that space will be there and any special character. So this is a generic method. So just a string to list. We have to pass the string and regular expressions. It will return the list, array list. So this is the method. See, states is a input and split is a method of one of the method of this string. Okay, so states dot split, we have to pass the regular expression. So whatever it may be, in our case it is a comma. If you see this one, regular expression, ex means regular expression. So it will split and it will return array. So arrays dot as list, Arrays is a class. If you see description here, this class contains various methods for manipulating arrays. So as list is a method which will return the array as array list collection. Okay, so finally we are passing the input as a string and we are getting a collection, that is a list. So we are checking input whether the input is present inside list or not. If it is present, then already so this is the configured values. List is a configured values. So input is already present. If it is present in configured values, then we will return the appropriate value from the map. This is the requirement. See, so first private static string. This is the static string which is defined, and this is the regular expression. These are not like this in the real time. It may be in DB or it may be from property file. This is regular expressions also. So we have to read from different places to make our program completely decouple. Tomorrow, so if you see recently, AP, United Andhra Pradesh bifurcated into Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. That time we have to add along with AP Telangana as well. So if that is a requirement, we have to go this file. We have to go this file string utility and update that TL. Right. After that, we have to compile and redeploy that one. It is a time consuming, which is tight coupled, which is not at all suggestible in real time development. So that it should be from the property file, or else it should be from DB. So tomorrow, if any new state added to our country, then that value will be updated into DB or property file. So that without doing any changes in this file, we can see that state as well. That is the beauty of decoupling the application. Okay, so here time being just a simple example, that's why I defined here. After that, I defined one map where I put AP like complete state name abbreviation as a key and state name as a value. So user will enter AP, we have to return Andhra Pradesh. If user enters KA, output should be Karnataka. If user enters AR, so output should be Arunachal Pradesh. These are defined by our Indian government, right? So these are the abbreviations. Okay, so then this is a scanner, S is equal to new scanner, which takes input as a file input destination system.in. This is predefined API. So after that, the system.out.println, we never use the system.out.println in our real-time examples. This is for just demo purpose I used. Okay, so please enter states abbreviations. So abbreviation should be this one. Okay, if user by mistake enters something else, it doesn't return anything. That has to be taken care in the program. So here our basic requirement is converting string into array list. Okay, so this is the one, string to array list. I already explained what this method will do. So this method is taking two arguments. One is the input string and regular expressions. In our case, comma. It can be hyphen, it can be space, it can be any special character. Okay, so this is also completely generic way of implementing the methods. Generally, in real time, people will refer this one instead of defining a method for a specific requirement. So it should be generic. If we can, if we cannot, we cannot do anything. Okay, we can go ahead with that one. If option is there, we have to go with generic, generalizing the code. Okay, So then we will get the list, configured list and input. So contains is a method of collection. So list dot contains input. If entered input is already present in list, then return the state name. This is simple, as simple. Let see. So we can execute this method in multiple ways. Right click, run as Java application, or else directly we can use alt plus shift plus x j like this, alt shift x. So it will show all the options bottom of right side. So we are going to use run as a Java application. You can just press j on keyboard. So it is showing here, please enter state's abbreviation. So this, we are in the line number 31. So if you enter, okay, that is one way. Second way, third is you can directly run this one from this shortcut. Just click this one, AP. See, state's abbreviation is AP and state name is Andhra Pradesh. For example, I will enter WB. Can you guess what is WB? Already we know, generally we are seeing outside, right? This is West Bengal. See, West Bengal. If you want to enter something else like KA, means Karnataka. See, state's abbreviation, this is the input and output should be Karnataka. This is how we can define, we can convert the string into list. Yeah, done my end. It's done from my end. Thank you for watching video.